this country was called Australia, but it has old names, ancient names, and I like to identify with those names and my father's country and my mother's country.
I think as Aboriginal people come together, we're still connecting to places, and we have those collective memories, whether it's our own stories or our family's stories or, you know, some of our ancestors' stories that have come before us.
And so I think it's really important for Aboriginal people in particular to look at different ways that we can maintain our connection. And, you know, you may not be living on your traditional country, but it doesn't matter where you are in Australia. You're on Aboriginal land.
Always was, always will be.
It was family orientated here, you know, all families knew each other, and as the years went by, people moved out, and, you know, young kids who were living here, they've got kids of their own now, and they still come down here to see one person. So I've still got the memories of kind of myself growing up here, you know. I've had that house 40 years now. We used to come down here and there was no boats here at all. We used to bring our little bucket with bait and fishing line, chuck the line in there and catch our dinner. And up in the domain there, all the big concerts were happening up there. Just how sad those people, the government mob around that round table, how they're thinking. When government wants to take this away and that away, they've done that all our lives, kind of thing. As I say, you teach your kids where they grew up, and they'll know it's their country.
Alright, you do a thumb, and you do a thumb.
I've always felt like La Perouse is a little bit more insular than the inner city communities. It's really like tight-knit, and there's a lot of connectedness, especially I think bonding around the sea, and the young people in this area are so resilient and so strong, and so they just have these really like boisterous characteristics that I think are going to be the markers of who they are going into adulthood.
You know, just those words to me just gives me a great sense of pride to know that we're still here and we're still fighting for our land, still fighting for our country, and even just now to have the privilege to bring my daughter down and put the ochre on and hear Uncle Dean speak and stuff, it's just, it just brings great pride to myself. Right now we're fighting for the recognition that we are the first people of this land, and that we are the rightful owners of this land. There's a lot of stuff that I feel that we should have a say in how this country is run, or what happens with this country, and I still believe that we're still, this country, the political system, or whatever you want to call it, was all built on racism.
We just want recognition. We want you to understand that it's everyone's fight, it's everyone's argument, it's everyone's problem, you know, until it gets solved.
Aaron, that's my cousin, and then that's Aaron's brother, and then that's another one of the boys. These two names, TJ Hickey and Pat Fisher, they're the ones that got chased by the police. He got ran over by the police because they believed that he was on a stolen bike, which he wasn't. Yeah. And that's like one of that's like the little quote they made. Yeah. Pretty emotional. Yeah.
We are still the highest incarcerated people in Australia. I remember Justice Wootton clearly stating in the Royal Commission into Aboriginal Deaths in Custody, either the Aboriginal people of this country are the most criminal element of this country or there's something wrong with our justice system. And I'll leave you to unpack that. Right. Respect the present, respect the moment that we're in, and work towards a reconciled and prosperous future where all our kids, irrespective of race, colour and creed, have the wonderful opportunity to learn about the oldest living culture, oldest living and breathing culture on this planet.
Redfern was a meeting place for a long, long time. It goes back even before the colony was there. You know that it's got this significance and people know that. I was a kid growing up here and that was in the early 70s. Everyone talks about generations and generations of people with their connection to all of this and this land way below the concrete.
Late 60s, early 70s, there was 30,000 people living here. You know, that was a solid chunk of all Aboriginal people in this state.
We used to have dancers. We used to all follow, the whole community followed Redfern All Blacks. You know, everyone used to turn out when Redfern All Blacks played La Perouse. Oh, it would be just a big blackout on the hill. And that's how it was, you know, and it's that camaraderie that I referred to earlier. That's what we had, you know. It was the, if one person, you know, took a punch, then that you were punching the whole lot of us.
People came down here to study, came down here to learn, but then they took that self-determination, they took that community control back home. I think some of the biggest issues we face here today in Redfern, Waterloo and really nationwide is still a struggle for self-determination from all types of government systems, from the care and protection system to the criminal justice system to the education system to the housing system. Each day we have to deal with adverse interactions with the police and train up our young people and to be the better man, you know, to walk away, to not let the police get the best of you, because there's a long line and long history of that in this community. Also here in Redfern, it's the home of gentrification in Sydney, so.
We know our solutions can't come from some academic and they can't come from somewhere across the ocean. It has to come from within our community. And to see that we're maintaining a footprint in a place that's being, I guess we're almost being displaced, it's crucial. And all of our organisations work together, that's what's going to make the difference.
You know, our culture is the thing that's going to save us, and that culture is the traditional culture, but it's also contemporary Aboriginal Redfern culture of self-determination, of community control, of activism. It kind of goes along with always was, always will be, but this will always be Aboriginal land because we're not going away without a fight. Despite the many years and the many government policies that were put in place to kind of strip us of our culture, that they haven't been successful, and that we always have been and always will be Aboriginal people.
I said we still stand strong.
We still stand strong. We still stand.
And we still stand strong.
Stand up.
I said we still stand strong.
We still stand strong. We still stand.
We fight for our people. Fight to be heard.
Always was, always will be. Always was, always will be. Always was, always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Always was,
always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Always was, always will be.
Die because of your disease, it's not as easy as your eyes to see. We've got to be that change. Fight to see this.
Always was, always will be.
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 Always was. Always will be.
Always was, 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 always will be.
This always was, and it always will be, Aboriginal land.